The member for Riverton.
Good morning, Madam Speaker. I'm so proud to stand before you all as the member for Riverton. Let me first of all acknowledge the traditional owners of the land, the Wajak people of the Noongar Nation, and pay my respects to their elders, past, present, and emerging. I'm acutely aware, Madam Speaker, I'm addressing the chair in historically auspicious circumstances. Congratulations on being elected as the first female speaker of the House, Madam Speaker. I'm proud to be serving under you in this House. With your permission, Madam Speaker, may I say a few words in my mother tongue. Hetheyamana arul nage, iriyoda yena aasirvada nage, janaseve maadudaga sikkida vaipuga, kodana kodi nandri. In my culture, Madam Speaker, we pay respect to our elders, and that's what I was saying in my mother tongue. I come from a state of Tamil Nadu in India. In that respect, I would also like to say a few words in Tamil, Madam Speaker. Yadum ure, yavarum keli. 3,000 years back, a poet, Kaniyan Pungundrana, said, Yadum ure, yavarum keli. The meaning of that is, any place is our place, any people are our people. He spoke about unity in diversity 3,000 years back. I'm really proud to be representing Riverton, Madam Speaker, which is the most multicultural community in the state. At this juncture, I would like to thank the contribution of the previous member for Riverton, Dr. Mike Nahan. On conversation with many people in Riverton, I came to know that he had served the electorate to the fullest ability. Though we do not agree with each other on our political views, one thing we agree on is making Riverton better. I wish him good luck, and I hope he has a safe and happy retirement. Madam Speaker, I was born in a town called Kotagiri in the Nilgiris district in the state of Tamil Nadu in India. It was a huge transition for me to move from India to UK and then moving to Western Australia, eventually making WA my home. During the process, I've had the opportunity to connect with various communities. I've always respected my connection with the elderly community. I've been welcomed by the Indian community and the Chinese community here in Western Australia. I have dealt with, starting from newborns to adolescents to young mothers and many sporting communities in the electorate of Riverton. And I'm looking forward to working across the board in serving the community in the coming years, Madam Speaker. Education is close to my heart for many reasons. As a kid, when my dad took me to the doctor, who was the most qualified person in town, I went into the room and said, "Good morning, doctor, how are you today?" That made my dad so proud. He was going about town saying, "My son can speak English." Today, I'm sure he's more proud that I'm addressing the assembly in Western Australia. My parents had a big dream of providing me with the best education possible, Madam Speaker. For their aspiration, there were reasons. My mom could not continue beyond year two because she had to care for a cousin of hers so that her aunt could go to work. to put food on the table. My father lost his father when he was 1.5 years of age. He was brought up in his maternal uncle's house. It wasn't the same as his own house. At the age of 15, after year 10, he had to give up his education because he felt he was obliged to contribute towards the income of the family. But that did not stop them from contributing towards giving me the best education possible in the world. I am thankful to them today, Madam Speaker. I would like to mention their names. My father's name is Krishnan Belli, and my mom's name is Saraswati Krishnan, and she is mainly known as Pachi Ammal. My community recognizes her as Pachi Ammal. I can remember the days my mom was sitting with me, though she'd only studied up to year two when I was studying late in the night. I remember the days my mom was repeatedly ironing my school uniform, repeatedly polishing my shoes to make sure I went to school spick and span. I'm very thankful, Madam Speaker, for them to have contributed towards my education. I'm really proud to say, and I'm very fortunate to represent Riverton, because people in Riverton have DNA of education in them. I'm proud to say I represent an electorate which has got three schools, two public, one private, Willerton Senior High School, Rosemont Senior High School, and All Saints College, all topping the table in the state over and again. People move into the electorate to be able to provide the best education for their kids, like my parents did for me. I'm very fortunate and proud to have made a commitment of $12.5 million to Willerton Senior High School and $35 million to Rosemont Senior High School, and also to primary schools towards STEM education. I know the people of Riverton are very proud to be providing the best education to their kids. Being a medical educator, an adjunct associate professor in Curtin University, and also a medical educator in Notre Dame University and the Royal College of GPs, I very often see medical graduates coming through either Willerton Senior High School and Rosemont Senior High School, which makes me even proud. I look forward to the next 4 years, Madam Speaker, with the help of our Education Minister, Honorable Sue Ellery, and the leadership of our Premier, Mark McGowan, to deliver the promises we've made for the schools and continue to fight for the pride of Riverton. My background is health, Madam Speaker. I graduated from JSS Medical College in the Mysore city of Karnataka.